Hi, I'm Tim Berglund with StarTree. Real-time analytics is an increasingly important new category. To understand it, I think we should begin by thinking of the world in terms of events. Now, an event is just a thing that happens. We'll make this little kind of explodey thing here. And that's just something that happens out in the world. That could be somebody ordering something, something being shipped. It can be just me taking an action, like viewing something on a website or doing a search in some application. We want to take that event and we want to become aware of it and we want to understand it. We want to know what happened and have some kind of understanding of that event so that we can take an action based on that event. And when we know about that event and when we take an action is very important. Let me draw a diagram here to illustrate. We're going to draw just a little graph. Here's time, right? And on this axis, we have the value of the event. Now, when the event happens, it tells us a lot about what's true in the world. So that is very valuable at the moment the event happens. That value declines precipitously, and as time goes on, the event becomes much less valuable. Maybe the relevance of that event, what it tells us about the world, is just less true as time has gone by. For example, if the event is me searching in a meal delivery service like Uber Eats or something like that, I search for hamburgers near me. Well, that's really important right now because presumably I'm hungry and I'm looking for a burger. 3 hours from now, it's a lot less important because either I ordered a burger or I found some other substitution. I'm probably not hungry anymore, so you can't really act on that. So this switch colors here. This part of the chart, this is what I'm going to call the real time. This is where real time analytics takes place, close to when the event actually happens. That's when there's the most value in understanding that event so that we can take action. There's a few different parties who are interested in analytics here around that meal delivery use case. There would be the internal analyst. This is kind of a traditional dashboard. How is this whole meal delivery business operating? What are things in aggregate? There might be somebody we'll call, the restaurant manager who is interested in how my restaurant is behaving. What were my sales maybe yesterday? Occasionally that person might want to know, what have they been in the last 5 minutes? Is some special order really causing demand to spike? Or it might be more this is sort of a general franchisee sort of use case. What is aggregate demand recently? How can I do inventory management? That's not really a real-time case, but it's something that somebody outside the organization would want to know. And then there's the user. There's me, right? I need to know how long is it going to take for my burger to arrive? And that's an analytics query. You have to roll up a bunch of results and present that to me so I can, in real time, make a decision about how to interact with that application. Now, let me propose a taxonomy here to make sense of the landscape and the different kinds of systems that might address different needs here. We'll start with this axis here, and this is going to be the who axis. Who is accessing the analytics? It'll go from internal users here to external users over here. Take another axis. This is going to be, get that arrow there, this is when. So up here is the real-time case, and down here is batch. All right, let's put some systems on the board and see what we've got. Down here in the internal and batch, we could have the legacy data warehouse ETL system. This is kind of old school systems. They had their origins in the early 90s. And very much an explicitly batch process oriented around creating reports. So you couldn't get really more down here. As you move up a little bit, you'll have more modern systems like Snowflake, very popular, successful, very useful cloud data warehouse. Again, in terms of latencies, ingest, and use cases, generally powering dashboards, generally longer latency queries. There are a number of other systems we might see here. We'd say Spark SQL, Trino, Presto. There's a lot of stuff in this space that are generally powering dashboards and more of a batch kind of sensibility. Up here, we would see, I would just call this the observability space. You might say, for example, Datadog, where we're ingesting data in real time. So there's probably Kafka is here. So that's making the management and storage of events very, very cheap and very quickly getting large numbers of events into a specialized database here, making the analysis available to internal users in real time. Observability has to be real time because things could be going wrong with our system, with servers, with processes in our system. We need to know about that right away, but that is for ops personnel on the inside of the business. Now let's look outside the business, these external facing things and more in the batch mode. I was talking about restaurant managers over here. So you might say just generally, something like the franchisee use case, the restaurant manager, the person who's outside the business, but needs to understand for like next day purposes, for handling inventory, understanding long-term trends. There's very much a case there for that person outside the external facing analytics, but still in batch mode. Now up here, I'm just gonna say in general, this is the realm of Apache Pinot, where we've got a purpose-built system explicitly for external facing queries in real time. Now, what do I mean by real time? Again, if we look over here, we're processing events, trying to create understanding so we can take action, very close to the time that the event takes place. So we don't want a lot of time to go by. And this is, this actual time span here, we don't have some kind of, fixed delta T that has to be for it to be considered real time. Generally, it's on the order of seconds, right? And the latencies, the query latencies we're gonna see here, if these are external facing queries, if I'm trying to order a burger and I need to know what the latency is, I want that to be measured, the latencies to be measured in the tens of milliseconds, not tens of seconds. Query concurrency might be like in the hundreds of thousands or millions of queries at once hitting the database. And the data has to be fresh within a few seconds for this stuff to work. So Pinot is handling these user-facing real-time use cases. Of course, it can really even satisfy internal use cases, no reason why not. And also there are batch ingest modes. There are real-time ingest modes and batch ingest modes. So going down here into the batch external mode, Pinot can also exist there. So it's really kind of covering, purpose-built for up here, but covering three quadrants of this space. And as people have figured out that it's interesting to take data from inside the business, the transactional history of the business, and expose it to users. That's a new thing. As I said, real-time analytics is a new thing. Before the infrastructure exists, people have tried to do it with other solutions. For example, people have tried and continue to use key value stores for this kind of thing. That can take a lot of work to make that work. Document search. Famously, LinkedIn, which is where Apache Pinot was originally created, originally solved some of their own user-facing real-time analytics needs with a document search cluster and required, say, 1,000 nodes to get that job done. After they built Pinot and deployed it on Pinot, migrated the workload, it was down to 70 nodes. So you had a 10x reduction in operating expenses and sometimes a 10, 100, or 1,000x reduction in the cost of an individual query. So some dramatic gains. And that's what happens, right? We get a new idea, we realize, hey, I need to take these events inside the business. I need to expose them not just to analysts and managers, but to actual users at scale with vastly higher concurrency, lower latency, fresher data, close to the time of when the event occurs in this real-time space. When that idea happens, a new category of infrastructure needs to emerge to take care of that. Happily, that infrastructure is here now. And if you wanted to understand what that phrase, real-time analytics, what it meant, very simply, we have an event, leads to understanding, leads to action. That used to take a day, now it takes seconds. And if you want to know more about Apache Pinot in particular, we've got a video covering it directly. There's a link in the notes. And if you want to continue to explore this space, whether it's Pinot in particular or just real-time analytics in general, you can always go to dev.startree.ai. There is an ever-growing collection of developer-oriented resources there. And you can join our Slack community. That's a great place to ask questions. We would love to have you there. So I strongly encourage you to check out those two resources. And as always, I look forward to seeing what you build.